Let's skate over here.
Hey.
Oh, where? Hey! Hey! Hey gang, how's it going? Welcome to Zendo USA. We had a cushion debacle. That's a fancy word for cushion debacle. Let me see.
Someone else is coming as a fancy word for cushion debacle.
Yeah, come on in, we've already started. No, you're good. It's hard to find it. Take off your sandals, grab a great cushion. We, I don't know if I ever told you. We'll talk. We're live too tonight, so no big deal. Hey,
no,
so we had a cushion debacle, folks. I just want to say quickly, Zendo USA, Tai Chi, we're gonna work it out. I want to say happy birthday to Mildred. She's 93 years old. Yeah. So thanks for your support. Appreciate
happy
it.
Happy birthday, Mildred.
Yeah. And all right, so that's it. Just basically, it's Tai Chi. We're going to run through tonight. We're doing a little meditation, a little Qigong exercise. I'm going to stop speaking to the camera in a moment because they said, not the new young lady, but other people have been here before said that I spent too much time with you guys. And there's no one out there. All right, so this is it. So that's it. Once again, it's mirror image. So if I lift up my left hand, you just follow what we're going on. All right, thanks. Welcome. I know, I'm trying to shorten it up. Just quickly, I'm Michael.
Mark.
Emmanuel.
Helen.
Allison.
Okay. So, thanks for being here, Ty. Are you okay with that cushion?
Just perfect.
All right. So, I'll let you know how the class goes. Evan, yeah, you said that. You had mentioned before I went away that we might get a lot. So, welcome.
Right.
Cool.
Yeah.
How do you know Evan? Oh, yeah, wait, we're okay.
Let's finish the
class. All right, good. Yeah. All right, good. Keep me on point. So basically, this is what we're going to do. What we're going to do is we're going to meditate. Oh, okay, cool. All right, now you're on. All right, cool. Well, welcome. And so what we're going to do is this. We're going to do a brief meditation, or we're going to do a Qigong exercise. Then we'll perform a brief meditation, or a little bit, and then what we'll do is Tai Chi. So what I'd like you to do tonight is that there's TV, there's camera, you can kind of see and follow. But I think for the most part, just relax. Breathe in slowly, exhale slowly. Just kind of follow everyone, and that's it.
Okay.
All right, thank you. But I will talk about our meditation for a moment. So when we do meditate, thumbs touching gently. Inhale through our nose, bring the air down to our lower abdomens. Exhale through our nose. And what I ask is keep our thumb on the roof of our mouth. And that's about it. We'll explain at the end of the term, you know, why and things of that nature as you go. But let's start with a Qigong exercise. So we'll start class.
Sangha.
So we'll start with a Qigong exercise. So we'll stack her spine, tongue in the roof of her mouth. And basically what we're doing is we're looking in the space or thinking about the space between our palms. And notice it's like my elbows are on a table. And what we're going to do, my palms are very close. Shoulders are relaxed, yes? And we're going to inhale. We're going to draw our fingers and our palms slowly away from one another. Yes? On the inhale. And then the exhale, we're going to bring our hands close to one another. Yes? And what we're going to do, inhale and exhale on your own. Let's get inhaling, palms spread out. And exhaling, palms close to one another. And during this exercise, as we inhale and exhale, think about the lower dot at the end. Yes, breathing down through the lower dot at the end. On the inhale. And then the exhale, we want to think about the energy being pumped up from our lower dot at the end and pushed out between our palms. Yes. Inhale. And as we inhale and exhale, exhaling. On this inhale, we want to think about that energy between our palms. As our palms move away from one another, we want to think about the energy between our palms, pulling our palms towards each other. So it's a polarity there, yes. And as we exhale, we experience an opposite polarity. where our palms now, are, the energy is pushing against our palms, right? So think about that. So inhaling on your out. Think about the energy between your palms and the ball of plasma, pulling your palms toward one another as you roll away. And as you exhale, think about the clarity changing and this ball of plasma is increasing, it's resisting your palms as it moves towards one another. That's our exercise design, just to get you moving on things. Good. So now let's go ahead and place our hands here. And what we're going to do is we're going to meditate for about 5 minutes. Just close our eyes. Inhale. On your own. Don't hold your breath. And exhale. We're going to inhale and exhale about an 8 to 10 count, okay? Just don't hold your breath. You also been doing this for a while. On your inhale, lower your hands closer, because you're not seeing it. And on the exhale, draw up on volume. One more breath. Inhale. And exhale. Exhale. Tapping. And when you tap, it should, you know, a little figure there. Side to side. Cover your ears, and you're going to do a clicking with your fingers on the base of your skull. And It should be audible. Yeah, you should be able to hear it. Chest. Once again, if these exercises cause anyone any discomfort, please modify. Chin going up and back. Modify the exercise. Chin going back down. Breathe. Chin up and back. In theory, we'd like to exhale as we're moving downward. Good. Chin down, chin moving to the right. Chin looking up, inhale smile. And chin going back down. Once again, modify the exercise according to your needs. Chin going to the right. Chin moving to the right last time. Hit him, smile. Pull me at center. Chin going to the left. Chin moving up. Hit him, smile. Head chin back down. Chin moving to the left. Moving up. And I'll smile. Last time, chin moving to left. Up. And I'll smile. Okay, good. I'm sorry. Go ahead, let's bend down. And once again, if these cause you any discomfort, modify. Yes, coming back up, rolling up, inhaling, and waving back down. Ugh, you can add your neck to it too. Take our left hand, place it on our right knee, and good inhale. And turning, and exhale, changing. So I'm compressing, yes, and then expanding, and then my turn, I compress my diaphragm area, and inhale. So this is giving a nice little massage to your internal organs. Yes, it's working your spine. Yes, just in your spine. Good. One last time to left. So, you know, a lot of us are sitting all day. The spinal cord work, as I was talking about, would say, like taking a dirty dish towel in your spine and just squeeze out all the dirt, yes, or all the impurities. So, we're giving our spine, yes, and spinal muscles a little bit.
Good.
Oh. Good, Rob. We're going to try to generate a little warmth here. We're going to place some on our kidneys over there. Yes, we can start the essence of life. Yes. Hold them there. Give it a bounce. Good. funny. Like every time I do this, I think to myself, I need to change this one up because I'm all nice and relaxed, and the shoulder, then this is a little tense. All right, so we make a hole. Yes, like that. So we're gonna go on our back of our spinal cord. All right, and so it's gonna look something. I'll be hitting my back of my spinal cord. Good. Exercise to kind of get our chi moving, yes? Kind of wake it up a little bit, kind of simmering. And then we meditate for a few moments. I call it defragmentation. Years ago, you'd have to defragment a computer, and basically the concept of meditation is you've been busy all day, and your thoughts are here, you know, health, work, family, vacation. And so you have all these files mixed up, yeah? So the concept for me in meditation is you give your mind an opportunity to take all these files and they're like, okay, work, vacation, friendship, put them all back in place so they're easy to access. So basically, and discard all the unnecessary files. So that's how I do meditation. So we'll just, you two, scoot back a little bit for a moment. All right, so. You can watch or you can move. But let's talk about the first couple of moves again. And Tai Chi is a combination of physical movement, right? Spirituality, all right? So it's just harmonizing my body, mind, and spirit. And also, it's a way to move slowly, allowing your body to adjust for balance. All right, so I think tonight, two things I'd like us to concentrate is on our index finger and our middle finger and our thumb, but mainly these two fingers. So anyways, archers, the way that I went. So the deal is that's what we're going to concentrate. So when we're doing cloud hands tonight, or whenever we're moving our hands, I want us to put our mind here. And imagine moving our fingers through this geometry. But what I'd like to do right now is I'm going to go over the first couple moves, and I want us to think about it because there's some finesses that are happening that I'd like to do. So I'll do it first. You can do it together. You can watch whatever you wish. But watch this. Look at this posture. My body is being elevated and moved forward, yes. As I become to the bow. Hit shoulder width. Bow. And as I come up, once again, opening the Bodha Dharma makes a pop. It pops open. Because inside this area, that's your truth, you know, that's your life, that's your Dharma. So we look at it, we see it. As we expand to the universe, we look up to the universe. To join universal energy coming down. And now, look, my index fingers take this universal energy and wash it down my body, or down my center core. Left leg bends. Steps out. Connecting universal energy and earth energy. Index fingers leading this. And then there's this beautiful, little just look at this. It's just beautiful softness here. As I create this loving glow here. Then there's a little energy cut. So the thing is, whatever you guys do is great, but since we were talking about growing in depth, you know, there's this little power moves. It goes from gentle softness gently, you know, like a little jolt of energy. So when we do that all together, and I'll talk, and then what we're going to do is just any questions.
Is there a particular height as you're coming back up to start embracing the loving universe?
Yeah, and that's a good question, because on this, when you're coming back up for the embracing loving universe, your shoulders are the most important. I think that dictates the height. So when you're coming back up, when you're coming up, and then you hear about shoulder width height, that's good. You get too high and it hurts your shoulders. So the object of many of the moves is like if you're way up here, then it's painful for your shoulders. So I just say shoulder height or a little bit low. Notice my elbows are still bent down. And then come, because that's a good question, because what happens, a lot of times people do this, but then that's not a natural movement. That's very awkward, it's painful, you know? So we're trying to avoid. And even when we're moving, you know, even here, when we're seeing a whip, you know, usually around shoulder height, elbows always down, elbows up. You know, it starts, this becomes stressful here, you know. So yeah, and just kind of dictate or something else. I was going to say, doesn't really matter. But just here, let's all just go here. So I'll go opposite to the right. And this here, creating loving universe, as we come up, we connected the universal energy to earth energy. And then, so we have this movement here, yes. And then it's about taking that energy and imagine it blossoming into this globe or sphere around us.
Yeah.
And there's something that someone does, I can't remember, but it's a whole shoulder thing. But we'll talk as we go. So let's do those few pieces together and then we'll just perform. Sound good? Any other questions? And then so here we just start, yes, and just relax. And then from here, it's like, even from here, it's like, boom, there's this little burst of energy, and then it slows down. And it's like we're floating through the universe, yes. We're gay just before you were born. This is before light. This is before everything. And then your birth. And now your birth. You open up your Dharma, and it's a pop, pop. And once again, you reach the universe for energy. Index fingers going up, looking upwards, accepting that energy, yeah, like spiraling energy coming down your body again. Encompassing you, bending your legs, opening up. Coming back up. And then right here, just fold your hands. Just let it happen. Remember your index finger and your middle finger? Feel that.
moving through the universe, collecting, sharing, experiencing this energy. So I move and then return to the right. And then my palms, it almost is a burst of energy. Chop. Why would dancing sea kelp form again? Remember your wrists move. Pinch. And then watch. Alright, so let's try that. So that's it. So we'll concentrate on this energy movement, especially in cloud hands. Single bit. And I'll talk a little bit. How you doing? You got a crappy foot today?
Yeah, a little bit. Especially
the hamstrings. Alright, cool. And if you can grab your just pull over things. Good? And let's do this. Always scoot over a little bit that way because I think I don't want to keep them. So breathe, relax, and the object of this, one last thing, is that you have your governor vessel and your conceptual vessel, yes, and they connect, and they call it, and connect that roof and mouth. So that's why we have a time in the roof and mouth. And during this whole thing, we're hoping, especially if she's gone, we think about that energy coming up, around, going down. So our last exercise, yeah, you can draw the energy up. Cool energy from the Lord on the end, and on with yourselves. If not, go on now. Alright, good? Alright, good. You good? Okay. And returning. Hands hit shoulder width apart, and then come. Do the best we can, opening the book of Dharma, reaching out to the universe, you know, because we're all interconnected by atoms. Yes, we'll talk about that. Yeah. Bending, stepping out with the left, returning, creating loving universe, shifting weight to the left. Center. Think about your palms. How do your palms feel right now? Coming in, huh? Pushing. Opposing energy from your palms to the earth. Setting them down. Dancing sea kelp. You're like string a kelp. And the ocean current is just wafting you. Yes. This beautiful ocean of energy. See? Boom. Stone door. Oh, that's it. Align your shoulders on this one. On the stone door. Cat. Cat's head by your knee. You're petting. It's arching its back and its tail. And then just let it go. Stomping guard. You got the chi ball here. Imagine your chi ball. Inhaling and exhaling twice. Yeah. The chi from lower down at the end is coming between your palms, creating chi, letting the chi grow. Exhaling, returning the chi to lower down at the end. Something like a little warmth. Yes. A warmth in your diaphragm area during this. Yes. Chi ball. Step. Single whip. Boom. It's like you're opening up curtains, yes? Everybody, the old days you had curtains, you'd open up and peek out the window, yeah. That's what we're doing here, opening up, turning, relaxing. Coming to cloud hands, up, 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 power, boom! Now, your right hand. Removing cloud hands, we're on the top of a misty mountain in the early 20s. Playing. Cloud hands. make these beautiful figure eights, yes, these infinity signs with their hands, yes. And look, it's a full body. Let's get an index finger, middle finger, concentration. That's fine. We're going to step out to the left slightly here. Qigong. We have a Qi ball here. Step out. Inhaling. Think about that Qi. You can feel the Qi from your lower at the end coming up, moving through your arms, out your palms, expanding. And then returning. Good. Bow to the emperor. Shift your weight. Qi ball presented to the emperor. Mind your back. Wings moving up. Fingers are splayed, palms and fingers relaxed, up, wiggle, 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 wiggle. Returning. And out. Good. Qigong. You're about to get bird to the right. Qi ball. Bowing, presenting the ball to the emperor. Wings are coming up. Wings are going back. So mind your shoulders on this too. So you don't have to reach too far in front, just on the side. Adjust on your heels and fall. Reach. Qigong. Imagine that Qi now drawing up your center, out your palms. Feel that warmth moving up. Your middle down to end. Exhale. Good. Chi ball. Single whip. Coming down. Cloud hands in now. Last time to the right. So right here, it's your hands are moving, your elbows are all engaged, your hips are engaged. It's a full body movement, yeah. Nice shing and yang, internal and external. Qi ball, stepping onto the right. Just all this gentle. Step. Little yang, yes. Step. The cat. The movement. That palm up. Patting the cat. Moving. Up. Gentleness gives way to. Yes. Brush the knee, I'm on the right heel, Qi ball in front, step brushing, elevate, play loose, sweeping back, very gentle step. Very gentle step. It's as if the energy is pulling you forward, yes? Draw back. Carry tiger. Gone.
Open up left heel. Open up right heel. Step, brush the knee. Palm up. Play a loop. Scooping back. Join. Nice. And this time, right step. It's like you're being drawn forward. Yes. Parry. And extra step with the right. Carry a mountain. Carry a tiger. Pushing mountain like a little baby tiger. Yeah. Good. Qigong. Open up left heel, palms face you. Coming in. Up. Bringing universal energy down, connecting with Earth's energy. Coming up. And your palms are in front of you, your arms are in front. See, not tight here, but in front and open. And I follow my left palm as I create this energy. I look at my right palm, there's this beautiful energy ball forming. I qigong here, go through my lower donkey and up. Chi ball in front, bending knee, lead with left. Right leg goes back. Horizontal, mind your legs, use your heels. Go into old man, just this beautiful old man tries on notes, sweeping. My qigong again. Sink. Ward off evil, shift my weight to left. Return to the right. Palms, I see my palms in this full. Ball, heel, toe, single whip, boom, and I just open up. It's like peeking into the curtain, yes. And notice my center line turns. My arms open up, my center line turns towards the front. Relax. Relax. Stepping forward right. Qigong. And then like go shoulder width apart, yeah? Just nice. Concentrate on our palms. Think about the energy moving from our lower dot at the end, returning to our lower dot at the end. Just take our time. Maybe we're moving too fast time again. And there's a beautiful swooping, like a bird swooping down, coming in, pop, open up the seeds, stepping into this old man. He's trying on his coat. I didn't fit too well. You didn't fit. Qigong. And I think about this beautiful spiraling energy around me. The energy is flowing, my chi is flowing, I'm connecting with the earth and universe here. Maybe I should go this way. Yes. Look. And then swoop, scooping down, sowing seeds, pop. And then let old man just happen. Ah, yes. Great calf stretch. Qigong here. This is what we all work for tonight, yeah. Right here. We're gonna try to summon that energy from our lower dante end and move it up to our upper dante end. Let's get that connected with the universe. Moving our energy. Coming up and watch us stepping out. Open up, and I slightly turn to the left, yeah? And my left palm is in front of my lower dantian without touching. My right palm covers my left without touching, so nothing is touching. And I inhale, elevating up. And I think about that energy in my lower dantian growing. Yes, exhaling.
Twining the spine.
Hmm?
You're twining?
Yes. Yes. Inhaling. And exhaling. And keep our hands very close to our body to get that energy flowing. Inhaling. Exhaling. Now, very slowly, take the palm closest to your body. Begin to draw it upward very slowly. And think about that energy. Can you feel that energy moving upward? Followed by the next palm. Now the palm is touching. But can we feel that energy being pulled up past our diaphragm? Sometimes.
you should feel a little tingling moving to our heart. Once we hit heart center, our heart area, still not touching, elbows bend down, you bend your head, both palms go around, bringing the energy from our lower dantian to our middle dantian to our upper dantian, pushing out, moving up, and expand the energy around you. I think Keith had mentioned this last time, guardian chi, but it wasn't the guardian chi that some people think of. All right, so that's about it, folks. How you doing, Keith? So what we're gonna do is, there's any questions? Yeah, so what Mark had mentioned is as we're moving, right? As we move, like Qigong, and it takes a while, but it's this finesse of thinking, like spiraling energy coming around at times, and then spiraling energy going down. Yes? So you have this movement of energy to get the chi going, upward movement, and then this downward movement. So yeah, there's these finite. So it's part mental, part physical. Yes, and I think about that. And when I'm opening up my hands, I'm thinking about I'm grounded to the earth. I'm drawing this energy up from my legs to my dantian, and as I go here, I think about that energy drawing upwards here to my arms, and where my palms are, I'm expanding this energy. I'm watching it grow in size, and I feel it moving up. And when I exhale, I'm compressing the energy, so I'm making it smaller, but increasing it in its potency, and I'm thinking about it going back down to my level again. So yes, and this spiraling helps. If that helps you. Yeah. And so at the end, the object is over here, is pumping, right? And I'm still doing this, and then as my palms move up here, I think about, now that all this coolness here, I'm drawing it upwards, my center core, yeah, my thrusting vessel. I'm going to think about here, and I'm touching, but I'm still drawing it upward here, and then I take it, pushing upward, and create, like, a globe. Conceptually, yeah. But the object is just to have fun, yeah. But if you get something more out of it, even better, yeah. And that's it.
So, huh?
Yeah. Are we out? Oh.
Did we run along?
Thank you. No, we ran about this time. So anyway, so yeah, that's what I was gonna say. On.